And welcome back. Well, for Valentine's Day, our next guest says the perfect gift combination is chocolate and a book.
I couldn't agree more. Carole Barrowman is here with some great books of love to recommend, but she says you're on your own for the chocolate. Carole is an author, English professor at Alverno, and reviewer for the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel. We're going to give away a book in just a little bit, which is exciting. I love chocolate. Do you?
I do too. Even after 35 years, I tell my husband, you can skip the card, you can skip the flowers, but I want the chocolate.
The chocolate, bring
it. Oh yeah, bring on the chocolate.
This is hilarious. We have a picture of some books you received on the same day.
Funny.
True?
I bought, all came in the same day. And so I put them together to make a story. I don't know if you can.
Look for her. Don't look for me. I can't read the other one because it's under.
Look for me.
Look for me.
And then.
Let me lie.
Sometimes I lie.
Let me lie and let sometimes lie. I lie.
And they're all in the same font.
Right, and what this does for readers, of course, is you're never going to see all those coming at once, but I get so many books that they all came across into my mail on the same day. But they suggest that those titles suggest a little message to readers that these are all going to be kind of Gone Girl kinds of books where you're not sure you can trust the narrator or not trust the narrator.
So it's not a mistake.
It is not a mistake, and it's not the same publisher. They're entirely different publishers.
Tailing off of the Gone Girl. But is it a formula that works or you get sick of it?
Yes, well, I get sick of it, but I'm reading so much in this genre. Most people, they're probably really like the book, those kind of books, and they like to be the twists and turns that come with them. And they're all very well-written books. Those are really, really
good.
I have actually read all of these for a future column.
In one day.
Yes, I tell you, you know that. I ignore my husband. I don't have kids at home anymore. But they do tend to have a little bit of a formula that puts them in that same area, you know?
So funny.
All right, we have 3 minutes left. We have four books to get through. Starting with Ross Poldark. Tiffany told me about this PBS series.
You haven't seen it yet?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I made her watch it. She loved it.
Oh, my gosh.
If you haven't seen Poldark, you must.
And you know, of course, the drinking game that goes with it, that anytime the main character takes off his shirt, you have to take a shot.
Nice.
So you're a little tipsy by the end of the show.
Go PBS, right?
Right, go PBS. This is a series that I got introduced to when I was a young, probably 13 or 14, and I wanted so bad to be Demelza.
Yes.
You know, the unrequited love, and then he falls madly in love with her. This is a swoon-worthy book, really well written. If you're not watching the series, I like this series better than Outlander, and I'm Scottish.
It's so good.
That's how good this
this is.
This is
English.
Yes. Yeah, it's really good. Set in England. It's a great historical drama romance. Yeah. You'll love it.
Good. Okay, so that's Ross Poldark. The next one, The Secret History of the Pink Carnation by Lauren Willig.
She is a very well-known name in romance literature, and what I like about this, it's the beginning of a series. You've got a modern day woman doing research for a dissertation, and what she does then is uncovers a female spy ring during Napoleonic times in Europe.
Okay.
But she falls in love with another scholar while she's paralleling a story of all these women spies in Europe. And so it's a nice blend of romance today and romance in the past.
Okay.
And you've got all these swashbuckling women. And this is the first one of the series. It's a great series.
Okay.
It was a fellow viewer who turned me on to it.
Awesome.
This is a great series. I loved it.
What about Roomies by Christina Lauren?
This is part of a trend in romance where you put two people together that kind of love-hate each other, and then eventually they fall in love. I mean, a wonderful story.
Yeah.
Who doesn't like those kind of stories? A young woman gets help in a subway after an attack by a drunk in the New York subway by a musician. Mm-hmm. Turns out he's a brilliant musician, and she gets him a break with her uncle, who's a director in Broadway. So he goes from being a street musician about to be famous on Broadway, but he's got a secret.
Oh, I like it.
He's got a secret. And of course, they fall in love, out of love, in love. They get married for reasons that are part of the book and I don't want to say anymore.
Love
but it's
it.
Lovely.
Okay.
It's
That's
lovely.
Roomies. Okay.
Roomies, yeah.
And this one, which you're also giving away, is Love, Hate, and Other Filters. It's by, how do you say the author's name? She's from Illinois.
Samira Ahmed.
Okay, and she's fairly local.
She's from one of the northern suburbs,
Batavia
in Illinois.
Potato,
yeah, right. This is a young adult novel, but every adult that I've recommended this to has loved it. It's about a young Muslim, a girl who is from an Indian family, so they've got her life all planned. They've picked out her husband. They've got all of those sort of traditions. She wants none of it. She wants to go to film school. She wants to be her own woman. And so she's trying to adjust herself to life and so on. And then there's a terrorist attack, of course.
It's a debut novel.
This is
author?
Her first novel.
Wow.
I know.
Good for
I
her.
Know.
Good.
I hope she'll come up to the blend. I think she'd be a really interesting woman to talk to.
That'd be great.
Yeah.
We're giving it away.
We're giving it
so
away.
So nice of you. Thank you.
Yep.
414-799-4444 is the number to call. Number 7 will win this morning. That book, Love, Hate, and Other Filters, which looks fantastic. If you go to barrowmanbooks.com, you can see Carol's full list of recommended books for love and romance just before Valentine's Day, which are some perfect choices, I think. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Always great to see you.
Yep, thank you.